We are doing Canto 11, Part 2, Chapter 24. This is Srimad Bhagavatam. We had done till verse 10 from Chapter 24, that is the philosophy of Sankhya. This is a chapter based on, it's a knowledge based. The path which is based on knowledge. So we had ended last time at something which was called as the universal egg. That means what we say as the Brahmand. So we are getting into the state of creation. How did the creation happen? And it's a part of Tattva Bodh. Basically, all the elements coming together along with the different gunas coming together and creating different kinds of stuff, which is like, see, the senses, the sense organs, so on and so forth. Finally, we have arrived. The whole thing is encased in what we call as the Brahmand. So we had ended over there. Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 11, Chapter 24. We are doing philosophy of Sankhya, verse 11. Sri Krishna is describing a philosophy to Uddhava. Now, this is a philosophy based entirely on knowledge. How do you achieve emancipation? By going through the knowledge media. How do you achieve that? This is what we are doing. So the verse says, Lord Brahma, the soul of the universe, being endowed with the mode of passion, performed great austerities by my mercy and thus created the three planetary divisions called Bhu, Bhuvan, Swar, along with their presiding deities. So now, last time what we had done was, we saw how the Divine Lord created this entity which we call as Prakriti. Prakriti, if you recollect, from the unmanifest came the manifest. So in between these stages, there is something which comes along called Prakriti. What is this Prakriti? Prakriti is Mother Nature. Now, who is the main proponent of this Mother Nature? What is it that drives the Mother Nature? First, it is always about creation. What is creation? Creation means everything is moving towards creating something in this world. So human beings also. You look at animals, you look at birds, you look at human, you look at everything in this world which is an animate being, one who is alive. What do? Their main focus in life is what? Creation, isn't it? So you will find that whether you take the chicken or whether you take a bird, whether you take an animal, like say for example a lion, a tiger, you name it, finally we come to human beings. What are they actually driving themselves towards? They are driving themselves towards creating another human being. And that is what is the driving force. So who is this driving force? There is something involved over there. So Prakriti is Mother Nature, which is, like I told you, she has got the powers within. If you recollect my, you know, previous week's satsang, you will remember there are powers. And what are these powers? These are different powers. We discuss the powers by means of the gods and the goddesses. What are these? These are nothing but powers. So we discussed about Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh or Shivji. Then we discussed about Lakshmi, Saraswati, you know, Parvati. These are the gods and the goddesses which have been given specific powers. Specific to their functionality. Now we come to this power which is called Brahma. Brahmaji is the creative aspect. He is going to create. Now Brahmaji is not physically going to put together, okay, as if, you know, he is going to put a clay together and say, and he is going to blow like, no, nothing like that. I mean, that is what has been thought of since ancient times, that God created a man out of clay and he blew life into it. Nothing like that. It's an elaborate process. How do you make babies? You think you do that? You put the clay together and you just blow into it and there you got a baby. Nothing like that happens. You know how big a process it is, no? Now think, Brahmaji is the precursor of all these things. He is called the power energy, the energy behind it. The power behind it. So what does he do? Lord Brahma, the soul of the universe, being endowed with the mode of passion, perform great austerities by my mercy and thus created the three planetary divisions called Bhur, Bhuvar, Swar along with their presiding deities. So Brahmaji first has to create the ground. Everything you have to, you just can't go over there and start, okay, let's begin. No, we can't do that. Okay? Suppose you are going to play football or cricket. Can you just go and take your stumps and bats and all those kind of things and start putting them wherever you want to and start playing? No, you need a ground, isn't it? You first need a very nice pitch. The ground has to be made. And do you know how much time it takes for the ground to be made? Go and ask the groundsman. He will tell you. It takes anywhere between 6 months to say a month or so, you know. That is the time that you take to prepare the pitch, to prepare the ground. And just before the match, imagine it rains. Then what happens? Everything goes for a toss. So now imagine, Brahmaji is going to prepare this ground for the human beings and the animals and the birds and everybody to come in. Right? So what is this that he is preparing? He is preparing the entire landing space. Okay, even when the man went to the moon, do you think he decided, chalo, let us take the moon and okay, we will crash over here? He didn't do like that, no? They must have decided well in advance where to land, how to do. You know that Mars rover is going on, you know? It's going somewhere, isn't it? So they must have selected. There might be storms, there might be a lot of problems there. So they have to definitely know where they are landing. So exactly the point which Brahmaji is doing. He is creating the ground for everything to happen. So first he has to create this thing called Bhur, Bhuvar, Swar. What is all these things? The idea that you need a firm base. Firm base. And on that, we can start the creation. So, if I need to have trees, if I need to have plants, do I need the soil or no? Definitely. Do I need water? Yes. I need the water, I need the soil, I need the temperature to be right, I need so many parameters are there that I got to tick. Okay, this is there, this is there, this is there, this is there, this is there. Then only I can start creating. Otherwise, how do I start? So Brahmaji is, before he is starting to plant, he is creating all these things in and putting them in place. So these are the things which he creates. So what are these three planetary systems? Before you do anything, remember there are the Vedas. That is, the rule book came into the picture first, right? The rule book says that we have to do this. Those who understand how companies are created, do you know first you have to write down the entire thing, and say who is going to own what are the things that we are going to do, all those things are there. So every function, what we are going to produce, what we are going to sell, how we are going to sell, everything has got to be written down. The memorandum has to be very, very detailed. So in the same way, Brahmaji is creating this very beautiful stuff, which is called Bhur, Bhuvar, Swar. So we will start this process. Now let us see what Brahmaji is up to. So, when he is creating that, what does he do? before you create that place, you need somebody like a chairman, a managing director. Somebody has to be, like, say, for example, when Facebook got created, naturally there was Mark Zuckerberg and there are two, three other people, isn't it? You require them. In the same way, when Alibaba got created, there was somebody called Jack Ma who was already driving force in it. Right? Now, let us say there is a new state getting created. Now, there was a new state created called Telangana. I'm sure you remember in India, a new state called Telangana was created. Naturally, when the time of creation, there was a chief minister, there were so many people appointed over there, they have to take charge. Right? So, in the same way, for this place to exist, first you need the people who will manage it. So, creating something also requires the force that will manage that place. Right? So, this is what he did. He created these three places and then he put presiding deities. Presiding deities are the managers of that place. Got it? Who is going to run that place? Somebody has to run the place. Heaven was established as the residence of the demigods. Bhuvarlok as that of the ghostly spirits, and the earth systems as the place of human beings and other mortal creatures. Those mystics who strive for liberation are promoted beyond these three divisions. Now, three divisions were made. What were the three divisions? Let us see what the three divisions are. First, you need to be somewhere. So that is the reason why earth got created. Right? Then, the next division was created called godly division. So there have to be gods. And then the third, which is called spirits, ghosts and spirits. Now you will want to know why these three kinds of divisions are there. Think about it. Even in our world, do we have something like that? Yes. See, one is good, one is bad, and one is in between, isn't it? So the bad is that ghostly one, good is the god, and in between is you. So either you can become god or you can become the devil, whichever one you want, you have the choice. Now tell me something, do the gods have the choice? No. First the god has to become human and then they can become a devil, correct? If devil wants to become god, can he become god? No. He has to first become a human and then he has to become a god. So you see, there is this gap in between. So he has to come, everybody, those who want to become the other, has to first come in the center. So now you will understand why gods can never become evil immediately. First they have to become human beings. Got it? So first, what did Brahmaji create? The netherworlds. Right? The heavens, the hells, and then in between. What is this in between? In between is a place where you can, it's like a via media. You can go from here to there, there to here. It is a very, very important location. What is this important location? You see, you want to go to a place, let us say, you want to go to Mysore Road from Alsur. Do we have to go to Majestic? Yes. So it has to pass through Majestic. So Majestic is a central location. So there always has to be a central location from where the diversion takes place. Like we say, the hub, the center of the wheel. Either I can go up or go down. There is always a center. So, nobody has the right to go up or down without passing the center. Right? So, if gods want to go to another place or if the devils want to become gods, they have to first become human. So, now do you understand the importance of becoming human? You are human today.
don't you think you have better chances than the gods? So we come to the fourth place. What is the fourth place? Why do you want to be trapped in these three places? Remember, as an evil entity, when you are in the netherworld, what is it that you will do? You will do all the bad acts, all the wrong things. You are going to, you know, well, you want to drink? Yes. You want to smoke? Yes. You want to do whatever you want to. Everything is available which is negative in nature over there. Can you get out of it? Doubt. There's a very big doubt in that. If you are a god, you have some functions. Like you are in charge of, let us say, education. Can you say tomorrow, I give up? You are an education minister. Can you suddenly say, I give up and go away? No, you cannot. You are not allowed to do that. You have to become a normal citizen first. Normal citizen. And then you can do whatever you want. So this is how it works. Now these are three levels, which is called the heaven, the hell, and the earthly domain, which exists in our world. Right? What happens to the people who want to go beyond? Beyond means sages, saints, realized beings. Where will they go? They have to go beyond these three. They have to get out of the system. Alright? So getting out of the system is the fourth layer. Can you share that? The fourth one. What is this fourth one? Those mystics who strive for liberation are promoted beyond the three divisions. There are three divisions. Beyond the three divisions, they will get promoted. Where does that go? Remember, all this started with what we call as a tangible world. Right? That means there is some kind of a physical form. Physical forms, what we see, this body, is called the food body. Below that, there are multiple other shells. One inside the other, one inside the other, like that. So, these are called the five sheaths. Sheath, S-H-E-A-T, sheath. So, they are one on top of each other. They are for the physical domain. Physical means you can use your senses, you can use your mind, you can use your intellect. All this will give you an idea that there is something like a physical domain in this world. Got it? But once you get realized, you are no longer in the physical domain. No. You lose the five sheets. They vanish. Why? Because there is no karma left in your world to perform. Karmic activity happens with these five sheets. So if you want to physically perform some action, do you need your physical body or no? Yes. You need a physical body. If I want to lift an object, I need a physical body. I need to be alive, breathing, correct? Then I need to have a mind. Somebody has to tell me, pick this thing up. So that object is required, you are required, your mind is required. Now there has to be something which tells me it is hot or cold. Can I touch a hot object? Oh, it will, you know, you will burn your hand, isn't it? So something has to tell you it is hot, it is cold, correct? This thing is required. Now, what were we talking about? A physical object. You are having a hot cup of tea. What are you having? A hot cup of tea. So physically there is a cup over there. There is tea inside that. So with your eyes, are you seeing that object? Yes. So your senses are involved. If you are not breathing, how can you drink that? So you need to be breathing, you need to be alive. Your body needs to be throbbing in and alive. Third thing, you need to have a mind to pick that object up properly. Suppose you have no coordination with your hands. You know, your hands are going to go like this. So you need proper coordination. So you need the mind to pick the cup up. Right? Now, when you are bringing it closer to your mouth, can you feel the cup? Yes. Can you see the smoke? You know, that vapor coming from it? That means it is hot. So what is the intellect telling you? It's a very, very hot cup of tea. If you drink it, you are going to get burnt. So what do? You cool it down. After you cool it down, now did you see all the four layers got used? Physical layer, which is your body layer, your breathing, mind, intellect, what is left? Enjoyment. So when you are drinking that cup of tea, so nice it is. Isn't that what you do? The enjoyment happens. So, in these three domains which we discussed as Bhur-Bhuvah-Bhuvah-Swa, these domains, that is the heaven, the earth and the hell, there is something which is called enjoyment. Enjoyment can also mean torture, by the way, okay? So in the hell, you are not going to enjoy that. You know how sadistic people are, no? They love this kind of tortures. Huh? And those who are masochists, what do? They'll cut themselves off. And have you seen that person, you know, beat himself up? You have seen, no? In the films and various other places in YouTube, you might have seen the person will take one hunter and he will beat himself. He loves to do that. He's enjoying it. Well, I can give you a better example than that. Shades of grey. 50 shades of grey. Enjoyment. Huh? So, that is enjoyment. Torture is also enjoyment, by the way. So the hell, there is the last layer is important. The fifth layer, which we call as enjoyment. Happy layer. It's not actually happy. Or the heavens. So all these three layers, which is the heaven, the earth and the hell, require these bodies. For the purpose, for enjoyment. And that is the reason why it is important to know that physically created objects by this mother nature get to have these kind of enjoyments also. But when the sage gets realization, his five layers disappear. So where is he going to go? He neither can go to heaven, he cannot stay on the earth, and he cannot go to hell also, because you need some enjoyment body, isn't it? And that body itself doesn't exist. So where will he go? So that is the reason why he says, promoted beyond the three divisions. Got it? Lord Brahma created the region below the earth for the demons and the Naga snakes. In this way, the destination of the three worlds was arranged and the corresponding reaction for the different kinds of work performed within the three modes of nature. So we come again to this, how these three modes of nature are defining what kind of place that we have to go to. Right? So what are these things that he is talking about? So we are now understood, the heaven is on top, between is earth, lowermost is hells. All the skeptics in the world will say, what nonsense are you talking? I don't believe in the heavens and I don't believe in the hells. All that is imaginary. You are just imagining those things. No. There is no imagination. These are within you. You. Now think, all this process was going on. So much I have explained, from creating this and Brahmand, and from this comes these three layers and then your tangible objects, all that kind of stuff what I discussed. Do you think it exists or it doesn't exist? The skeptics will say, all this is hogwash. It doesn't exist. Just like Hogwarts. It doesn't exist. It's a joke. So, what exists? It exists within you. And what are these things? These are called the layers in our body. We have seven layers of heaven within us. Okay? We have seven layers of earth within us and the seven layers of hell within us. So 21 total. It is within us. Whether we want to rise in life or whether we want to sink in life. Rising in life is within your hands. Sinking in life is within your hands. When you do something bad, do we sink? Do we definitely say that this person has sunk so below? We say these words. And when you say this person has risen in the eyes, means what? He has risen higher and higher. We say this, isn't it? But we don't understand that what we are talking is very much within this domain of what we call as the heaven, the earth and the hells. Now we are going to go into the in-between layers. What is the in-between layer? The in-between layer, Brahmaji describes as the layer for demons and nagas. What are nagas, by the way? You know what nag stands for, no? Snake. So there is a level, there is a place for this snake. So we called it the snake world. And then there is another layer which is called the layers for the demons. Are the demons same as devils? No. There is a new Harry Potter series which is coming. Okay? There is a new movie that is coming. You know what is the name of the movie? I kill the giants. Do you know about it? There is this young girl. Okay. And she believes in giants from her childhood. And she tells her sister. So, elder sister is played by Zoe Saldana. And this younger girl keeps on telling her, there are giants. And the whole town doesn't believe in her. But this girl makes preparations to kill the giants. Now you may say, what are we talking about? There are no giants in this world. It's all imagination, isn't it? If you go to the Bible, all these holy scriptures from the Jewish and the Christian world, they also talk of this. And the name for them is Nephilim. Okay? Go and read it, you will find. These are giants. See, if I tell you there are giants, you will not believe. Okay? But if some of these great, you know, film producers, when they create these movies, they show those big giants coming, you will believe in that. Okay? So, right? The Japanese people created King Kong or that. What is that? Kong. And we believe that there is going to be a very giant ape who is going to come. We believe that. We believe all those people from outer space are going to come. They are like big giants. But according to us, it is an imaginary world. Brahmaji is talking about these kind of demonical creatures. Okay, they exist. But unfortunately, we cannot see them. Why we cannot see them? Just like we cannot see the devil, we cannot see the demons, we cannot see the snake world people also. Do you think there are snake world people? According to us, it doesn't exist. No, they exist. But how do you know whether they exist or not? Correct? So you need to have some amount of, okay, let us try, you know, take it with a pinch of salt. Okay, it exists. Now, this has become more like a Harry Potter book now, you will say. No, it's not like that. There is a world where people exist at a different level. Those who have seen the movie Andre the Giant. Have you seen Andre the Giant? No? Game of Thrones? Have you seen that giant guy? Huh? You know, he looks like a 7-footer. As if he can catch us like this and crush us. Like that. Believe me, if there is this kind of a physical person there, don't you think that there is a spiritual person like that also, only in the spirit form? So there exists. Unfortunately, we do not have the eyes to see this kind of things in this world. And because they exist, we are in no way to deny this. Okay? We cannot deny this because we do not have that knowledge to know these people. Okay? So let me just give you this as a storybook. Okay? Just take it with a pinch of salt. Think. There is a world which is far beyond ours, physical domain, and these kind of creatures do exist. So we have a snake world which is called the Nagalok. What kind of snakes are there? Different kinds of snakes. Yes, yes, yes. Anaconda also included. Yeah, you can have the movie, you know. You can Anaconda type of snakes are also there. But what are these snakes? The snakes are creatures from another domain. They do not exist from our domains. Okay? So they are there. By mystic yoga, great austerities and the renounced order of life, the pure destination of Maharlok, Janalok, Tapalok and Satyalok are attained. But by devotional yoga, one can achieve my transcendental abode. So now in this, all these are called worlds, W-O-R-L-D-S, worlds. So what are these different worlds? These are Maharlok, Janalok, Tapalok, Satyalok. These are called different worlds. They are within you. Those who meditate, in meditation, they can achieve a certain domain. Okay? So you will find that those who are meditating can have access to this world. Now, if I were to ask you this question, do you think only this internet is there? What you www.whatever.com? Do you think that is the only world there? No. There is a whole load of underground network which we don't know about. There is a network called the Tor network. We have absolutely no clue about it because we are operating in the material world. Huh? Do we know about this kind of the dark web? Do you know that? No. There is a dark web out there and we don't know a thing about it because we have never ventured into it. If you venture into this dark web, you will understand what kind of things exist. The hackers in most of the movies you have seen, they do not leave any trace behind, isn't it? They operate with these networks and they exist within our world. So if in the internet you can have so many divisions which you don't know anything about, can this universe not have these divisions? So the creation also has multiple divisions. And in the multiple divisions, these things do exist. And that is the reason why whatever we are learning today may not be physically possible for you to approach. But if you are in spiritual, you can definitely go to these domains if you wish to. Yes, it is possible. So, by mystic yoga, mystical yoga, great austerities and renounced order of life. What happens? When a person enters the spiritual world, what does he have to do? He's supposed to use the mystic yoga. Yoga is, last time we had understood, it is nothing but the pathway to some great domains, correct? It's a path. With these great austerities, if you perform great austerities, we have discussed austerities in the past. Tapasya, we call it. And the renounced order of life, you renounce this world, you become detached from it, you do not consider yourself as a part of this normal human world. Though you may be eating, drinking and living in the way a normal human being is doing, but you are nowhere in this domain. You don't operate. So such a kind of a person, the pure destination of Maharlok, Janalok, Tapalok and Satyalok are attained. All these lokas which are on the higher planes, higher planes. Before this we discussed the Nagalok. Before this we discussed the demonical place also. This is on the higher side. That was the lower side. Now this is on the higher side. What is there on the higher side? Different lokas called Maharlok, Janalok, Tapalok and Satyalok. So you can attain them. But on realization, what happens to you? You go beyond all these domains, far away, beyond, because you do not have the bodies to enjoy it, correct? So, but my devotional yoga, one achieves my transcendental abode. So, if somebody is performing the yoga, which is connected to Krishna's domain, person will reach Krishna's world. Got it? All results of fruitive work has been arranged within this world by me. The Supreme Creator acting as a force of time. Thus one sometimes rises up towards the surface of this mighty river of the modes of nature and sometimes again submerges. So fruitive work. In the material world, what do we do? We do fruitive jobs, that means jobs which will give us a certain place to achieve, something to go to. Like if I am working, I need the money. So the fruitive work means I am doing some work, I need to be paid certain salary, correct? That is called a fruitive work, right? All kinds of fruitive activities, including producing children, including getting married, that is a fruitive work. There is a fruit, you know. The child is the fruit, isn't it? Isn't that what we started with? Everybody is into this for the purpose of regeneration, for generating more and more and more and more. So, that is also fruitive work. So, fruitive work is that which gives us results. So those who are interested in fruitive work, they have been arranged in the world by me. All these fruits, whatever that you desire, whether it is money, power, fame, fortune, you know, conjugal bliss, children, old age, death, everything has been arranged in this world for you. Everything. Whatever you wish to have. How much do you wish to have? Do you think there is an end to all these things? No. Is there an end to how much a person can earn? No. Is there an end to how much a person can become zero? No. You know, there is a zero below that also, there is something. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 is also there. So it is not that you can stop at zero, you can go to minus levels also. Do you know that or no? So a person can fall down below the zero level also. Right? So what is Krishna saying over here? He says, all results of fruitive work have been arranged within this world by me. I am the supreme creator acting as a force of time. So through the working of Brahmaji, remember Brahmaji is the function that we were talking about, creation. What is he doing through that? He is creating these different fruits. Thus one sometimes rises towards the surface of this mighty river of the modes of nature and sometimes again submerges. What are we talking about over here? Man can rise higher and higher and higher in his life. Now, when I talk of higher and higher, you are thinking in terms of money. No? Oh, we are talking about few hundreds, thousands, you know, millions, billions, trillions. I don't know after that what comes. Quadrillion. So, we are thinking only in that. No. Here I am talking in terms of how good can you become. You know, goodness. The mode of goodness. Do you remember mode of goodness? Very good. We are living in the mode of passion. Human beings live in the mode of passion. You know that, no? And the demons? All tamasic. Below. So, when you rise higher, means what? You become good, better, best. Beyond that, there must be something, you know, best of the bestest or something like that must be there. Or maybe beastie or something like that. I don't know. So, we can rise higher or you can go lower. So, here what is Krishna telling us? That sometimes a man cracks the ceiling. Sometimes. He can touch the highest level. What is this river of life? River of life is an imaginary thing which exists in our domain, in this material world. We are constantly getting churned in the river of life. Just imagine, in the river there are fishes. The fish will give birth to a fish only. That fish will give birth to another fish. And that fish will give birth to another fish, isn't it? That's what is going to happen, isn't it? And they are going to flow in that same place. Suppose it's a big lake. It's an ongoing cycle, isn't it? Sometimes you can rise higher. Rise higher means become better and better and better. How does a person become better? Isn't that what you will ask? To become better, what are you supposed to be doing? Well, what you are supposed to do is simply keep on going ahead and ahead and ahead, not bothering about results. That means what? In the material world, if I do some good act, you know, somebody sent me money, that person was expecting, I should say, yes, I got it. There was no response. Did you get it? Yes. Got it. No, I just wanted to confirm whether you got it or no. Now, if I have got it, I have got it, I will tell you so. But it doesn't mean that you have done a good job, you are supposed to go and ask 10 times and get a confirmation about it. Please understand, in this material world, do not stop for getting praises. Human beings love praises. So you will find that your mother is always hovering around you after she has served you a nice meal. She is expecting you to say something about the meal that she has cooked for you. Isn't it? Then you say, Mom, it's very nice. And imagine you saying something completely contrary. There was too much of salt in it. And you know what is the answer you will get? I make it for you. I get up in the morning. I cook this thing for you. And I make it the best possible way. And yet you are saying something bad about it. That is called expectation of results. You understand? You see, there was this World Economic Forum going on. After the speech was given, you know, people clapped. I imagine there is a speech given and nobody claps. We are all expecting results from it, isn't it? So if you are doing something nice, you are hoping somebody is going to say something nice to me. But this, what I am talking about, is not stopping in the way. Don't stop for accolades. Don't stop for getting praises in this world. And don't even stop when somebody is going to trash you. Just keep on moving to the next level, to the next level, to the next level, to the next level. This is the way you can go up. So going upwards is exactly like this. If you want to reach the surface, don't look back and say, how did I swim? No. You are supposed to touch the surface. Okay, have you seen that movie Finding Nemo? You know, he's told you can't cross this, you cannot go here, and you cannot go there. And what did he do? He went beyond. So when you go beyond, what happens to you? You find better worlds. There's a story of Ramakrishna Paramahansa where he says, there is a woodcutter. So one day when he is going to cut the wood, there is a sage who passes by and he says, why do you have to cut over here? Why not go ahead and cut somewhere else? So he goes ahead. So when he is cutting the wood over there, he finds a silver mine. He becomes rich. But then one day he remembers, the sage has said, go ahead. Did he say stop? No. So he goes ahead and finds a gold mine. Again he becomes more richer. Then again he remembers the sage, the words of the sage. What does he say? Go ahead. So he goes ahead and he gets a diamond mine. So this way man is supposed to constantly go ahead and not wait for results. Results are a part and parcel of our material domain where we are having expectations. The expectations are very, very sad. You know, those who are having no jobs, I always tell them something. You know what I tell them? Make 100 applications, make 200 applications, make 1,000 applications, and don't stop. Don't stop. When did I say stop? I got a good job. So does that mean STOP? No. You know, what does it mean very simply? It means like this, that you have got a job which is giving you 40,000 per annum. So time will come 6 months, 1 year down the line when you are going to get dissatisfied and you will say, I want more. So you get 70,000 per annum if you join the next one. Are you supposed to stop over there? No. Did I tell you that there is a ceiling to how much you can get? No. So in the same way, you'll get 100,000, you'll get 200,000. You think that you should stop over there? Maybe you'll get 1,000,000. After that, you can get 10 million. Don't stop. So in the same way, when you're applying for jobs, don't stop. Keep on applying. Don't be satisfied in that one place that you are in. Why? Did I tell you that you should be, my boss, you know, he praised me to the heavens. I am most suitable person for this job. And that is the worst thing that you can do. You are not the most suitable person for the job. You are replaceable. You can be replaced. So your job is to keep on going ahead. So in the spiritual world also, your job is to keep on going ahead and ahead and ahead and ahead and ahead. Don't stop anywhere. So when you come to the surface, still you are not supposed to stop over there. Nobody has said that you are allowed to stop. No. What do people do in old age? By the time they are 60 or 65 years of age, what do they say? I'm so tired of my life, you know. I want to take some rest. I am retired now. I don't know what I'm going to do. Then what do they do? Watch TV? Drink beer? Isn't that what people do? Gossip? If you go to all the villages in India, you will find that there is a gossip corner for everybody. You think there is no gossip corner in offices? You know the water faucet or where you collect your coffee mugs from? It's a very good place to go and gossip. There is a location for every place in every domain. There is a location where you can go and chatter. So in the same way, in the material world also, there is a place. So don't ever stop. Again, those who fall down. You know, those who fall down, how do they fall down? So we are seeing the next line, sometimes again submerge. You know what happened? What do you mean by submerge? Go deeper down into the gutters. How? The person will say, okay, I'm going to have one cup of tea. From one, it will become two. Now let us translate it into liquor. Let us translate it into tobacco chewing. You know, chewing tobacco is a great thing in India. What do? They call it khaini, khaini. That day I was sitting outside the railway station. There were two young boys. They must have been 18 or 19 years old. They were from some other state. They were sitting and this person, I was just watching him. He removed tobacco and he removed, you know, slake line. And he created a very big lump of that thing. It's called khaini. And then he put it in his mouth. And then he sealed the packet and put it in his pocket. So the neighbor is asking, "Hamko bhi do, give me also." And this is a very, very common thing. It leads to cancer, no? In the same way, more and more drinking leads to cirrhosis of liver and various other diseases. In the same way, more and more drugs, what does it lead to? Wrong things. So, I hope you understand that this is what happens in this material world. Either you can rise higher or you can go deep down under. So, we have arrived at an understanding that Brahmaji, he created these three different worlds. One was the heaven. One was the earth and one was the hells. Now we are going for the classification. Those who are realized get out of this world. They go beyond the three domains. Now we are going to do the next classification. How many heavens are there? How many hells are there? What is there on the earth? So he said that there is a Nagaloka. There is a place where the demons stay. Like that, there are various domains. Like that, there are different places where the people can rise higher and higher and people can sink lower and lower. So this is in turn the way in which this entire universe has been divided. Unfortunately, people we think that there is no such thing existing. We are using our senses and our mind to try to decipher this. But please understand, this is beyond our normal canon understanding. So let us stop at this and we shall continue from verse 16 the next time.